Hey, kia ora, I te aroa ma'ata o te ātua. Welcome to Tagata Pasifika.
We're going hard with our Cook Islands language this week. Te mata ora nei tō tātou arāweianga no te epitoma o te reo Māori kuki airani on the show today. It's Cook Islands Language Week, but there are concerns about the lack of young people speaking the language.
E tāma ni tā mātou reo Māori, no te mea kāngaro ia te tā mātou reo. Me kāre tātou e tāma ia.
It's strength training this week for the Butterbean.
You want a belt or you?
Oh, should be right.
Yep.
I need a belt around my heart.
And Valerie Adams working her way back from injury to compete at the Rio Olympics.
I feel pretty good. I'm very blessed to be here. I'm very blessed to be able to continue what I do.
I te ia tai mera, te ia tō tātou noti Pasifika. Tatau ia e Seinafolava Sanele Chadwick. Kia ora.
Thank you, John, and thank you, Marama. Well, a Tongan community leader is urging the Transport Minister to improve a stretch of road near Katikati that claimed the lives of 5 Tongan men earlier this week. The men died instantly when a logging truck collided with their car as they were pulling onto State Highway 2 near Tauranga on Tuesday night. Tongan Advisory Council spokesperson Milino Maka says immediate changes are necessary.
The sad thing about this, they know this stretch of road is, you know, it's quite dangerous. But often you ask a question, why you have to take 5 lives for them to really have a good look at it, you know?
A memorial service will be held at the Tongan Methodist Church in Mangere tomorrow. And a Give a Little page has been set up to help raise funds for the victims' families. We'll have all the details on our Facebook page. May they rest in peace. Toka a I ngonga ai aiki. Well, a health expert is warning women against travelling to the Pacific Islands following the Ministry of Health's latest Zika virus update. The ministry is advising women to avoid Zika-infected countries, or if that's not possible, to delay their pregnancy for at least 8 weeks following their return to New Zealand. Health Registrar Dr. Lavinia Perumal says travel should be avoided because of pregnancy risks.
It can affect the unborn child if it's transmitted from a pregnant woman. And in that unborn child, it can cause serious neurological problems, brain abnormalities, and that'll affect the child for the duration of its life, but also it can put the pregnancy at risk.
Countries affected include Fiji, Samoa, American Samoa, and Tonga. Well, it's been more than 20 years in the planning, but the Samoa consulate in New Zealand has moved to South Auckland. Guests and dignitaries celebrated the relocation of the Samoa consulate in Mangere after it officially opened its doors last weekend. The multi-million dollar whale is the largest of its kind in the world and will include office spaces and a retail area. Consul General Fa'alotoi Rupenapongi says the move will allow them to be closer to the Samoan community.
I think it's mainly the easy access with transportation. You know, they don't have to worry about coming that far, and also the parking. And the whale here will be available for community activities at a charge, of course.
The consulate was previously located on Auckland's Kay Road to serve the central Samoan community during the 1970s. Well, the Christchurch Pacific community is in mourning this week following the loss of Pacific pioneer Tufunga Haloato Nesi Langatule. The 78-year-old left Niue at the age of 17 and spent close to 60 years in the Garden City supporting and advocating for Pacific people. She leaves behind 6 children, 18 grandchildren and more than 25 great-grandchildren. Koe matalehake lotu motu mo e fiefie ke hautau tangata, whanaua koe mo e monuina, to manatu tukulangi e mautolo a koe. Well, the drive to recruit more female Pacific Islanders into the police force was one of the main points raised at an internal support whānau in Auckland last week. The annual whānau acknowledged 75 years of women in policing and looked at recruitment and better ways to work with communities. Only 5% of New Zealand's current police force is Pacific, and National Police Pacific Strategic Advisor Peter Stokes says that number needs to grow.
We're saying, you know, come and join us, come and become part of it. Because we're looking for language skills, we're looking for, you know, cultural skills. You can bring them in and you can utilise them here.
Only 20% of New Zealand's police force are women. And that's your Pacific News. Back to you, Marama and John.
Thank you very much, Seinafolava.
Me take mata, Seinafolava. Thank you.